Hello and welcome to my feature highlights in January 2025 with SAP Datasphere. What a great start into the new year with lots of new features and enhancements with our two January releases. So let's check out my top features. The first one, transformation flows. So there are two new options available in the monitoring for transformation flows. The first one, you can now simulate a run. The simulation will not write any changes into the target table. So simulating allows you to test the transformation flow and see if you can get the desired outcome. Based on the result, you can decide to deploy the flow, resolve errors, or to optimize the flow to improve performance. The second option is the ability to generate PlanViz files. The PlanViz file contains detailed information about your data model that you can download for further analysis. Analyzing this file allows you to resolve errors and enhance the transformation flow performance. Both are great new helpers during your development efforts. In addition, we also added a Python operator for the file-based spaces sitting on the object store persistency. You can insert a Python operator to transform incoming data with a Python script and output the structured data to the next operator. The Python script operator is available for code-based transformations leveraging Python libraries like built-ins, NumPy, and Pandas. So the next features are with replication flows. If you are using an existing table as a target for your replication flow, this table may contain columns that don't exist in the corresponding source object. So previously, you'd have to remove each of these columns manually in the table editor before you could start your replication flow. Now you can choose to ignore these columns during the replication with this new setting. In addition, we also enabled the export of replication flows to a season JSON file from the data builder editors, like you know it from the other design time artifacts. And of course, you can also import it from that file. The third one, SAP Business AI. There is a new global role called Data Warehouse AI Consumer now, which enables the users assigned to it to use SAP Business AI features provided by Datasphere. As a prerequisite, you require an entitlement for SAP AI units, and the AI features need to be activated in your Datasphere tenant on the new Configuration AI Services tab. For more information, check out the SAP Note 352-2010 for more details. With that, we also delivered the first AI feature in the catalog of SAP Datasphere. So when enriching catalog assets on the asset details page, you can use the Business AI feature for adding a custom summary, custom long descriptions, and assigning tag and tag relationships. So all in all, very cool features helping you to use SAP Datasphere way more efficiently. Thanks for joining me this month for the Datasphere highlight overview. And of course, don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel to get the latest updates. Take care and see you soon.